Hello everyone, this is Professor Vishal Maitre. Along with me is my colleague Professor Shripad Desai. We are from Bharati Vidyapeeth Deemed to be University College of Engineering, Pune. So today's module we are going to represent on short circuit analysis using ETAP software. So in the previous module we have covered about how to represent a single line diagram in ETAP software along with the load flow analysis. So let us start with the short circuit analysis. So I'll go directly to the ETAP window. So here we have designed a small model which is having 5 wind turbine generators connected to 690 volt bus, which is stepped up to 33 kV with the help of the transformer, which is 3 MVA, and which is further connected to the grid. Grid is nothing but which we are having it in a swing bus. So let us double click on the wind turbine generator 3. So it pops up a new window which gives the information about the bus ID. This bus ID we can change. For example, if I want to change it, suppose if I gave this name as India, yes, it will show you display the same. Bus 2, it will display which is connected to bus 2. Now here we have considered type 3, that is doubly fed induction generator, and we are going to control a generic model, that is control for reactive power. If I control click OK, the bus ID which we have given is displayed on the screen now. So here accordingly, whatever the description bus name you have to give for that wind turbine generator, you can provide the name. The same specifications are applicable for the remaining 4 wind turbine generators. As this is a small model, just to understand what is short circuit analysis, we have considered a small model. So the same can be applicable for a complex network or an entire power system, a complex network which we are considering. So this window is popping up after every 30 minutes. You can save that particular window. Now the procedure for how to run a short circuit analysis in ETAP for this particular model. So first we need to select go on short circuit analysis. Now here the fault can be created only on bus for short circuit analysis, because the bus is nothing but where it is a junction point. So wherever the short circuit current is occurring, we can measure it at that particular bus. So here we are having 2 buses, bus 2 which is operating at 690 volt and bus 34 which is operating at 33 kilovolt. So let me consider bus number 2. So I'll right click on it and create a fault. So as soon as you create a fault, the current color of that particular bus changes, indicating that you have created a fault at that particular bus. Now let us go to the display options of this right side tab, is for running the short circuit analysis according to the duty which we have to perform on the short circuit. So here is the duty option, which is as per NCC 37 standards, which is running a 3-phase device duty. Now here this max is going to display the results for, if we want for 3-phase line to ground, line to line, and double line to ground fault for half cycle. Now the same parameters we can analyze but with 1.5 to 4 cycle, and this minimum is for 30 cycles which we can perform the same analysis. So let us start one by one. Let us start with the maximum. If I select maximum, now here we can see maximum, that is for, we have considered, if you want to see, you can just see here, it is for half cycle. Now it is, the duration is very small, it is half cycle, so the current is going to be maximum. So the maximum current which is flowing is 61.05 kiloampere. Also we can see that operating voltage of bus is 690 volt, which has dropped down to 500 volt. So that is the drop down into voltage. Now when the short circuit is occurring, the potential is going to drop down and the current is going to increase at very high rate. So the current is increased to 61.05 kiloampere. Now if the same result, or if the same analysis I do for 1.5 to 4 cycle, now we can observe that the 61.05 kiloampere now has dropped down to 57.68. Now we have considered more number of cycle, so for more number of cycle, as you go on increasing the number of cycle, the short circuit current value at the faulted bus is going to go on decreasing. Again if I select for minimum 30 cycle, so this is the You can say the lower limit of the short circuit current, that is 34.49, and the upper limit is the maximum which we have considered, 61.05. So the operating range of that short circuit current is 34.45 kiloampere to upper limit, that is 61.05 kiloampere. Along with this, now this is what we have observed, the range of the short circuit current. Along with this, if we have to consider a duty cycle, that is for three phase. Now for every particular branch, it is showing the operating voltage after the short circuit has occurred at bus number 2, along with the contribution of the short circuit current along with the direction. So if we see 13.48 kiloampere current is contributing from the wind turbine generator, the direction of arrow is shown upwards, and from the grid side it is 0.72 kiloampere which is contributing downwards towards the bus number 2, right? So this is the analysis. If we have to change the if we have to change, or we have to check which type of short circuit current is this, so we can just go to the display option, and it will show you it is for three phase. But if we have to check for single phase, I'll click on max. It will show you the display options. Again, go to display option. Now this is my fault type is three phase fault. I can change it to single line to ground. If I select single line to ground and click OK, it will show me the single line to ground current, short circuit current, how much is flowing. Again, if I go to display option and select now line to line fault is zero, because we haven't considered the other line. It is at the same potential, so the short circuit current will be zero. So here we will have only one type of fault, that is line to ground. When we consider two or more than two types of fault simultaneously, then these two options will be available, that is line to ground, double line to ground and double line fault. So now let us see. I'll remove this short circuit fault now and create a new fault on bus number 34. If I create a fault here, again the color had changed, that indicating that we have created a fault. Let us observe the same analysis. So if I select now the maximum, now here we are observing that the short circuit current is 39.3 kiloampere. Now when we had created the same fault at bus number 2, the short circuit current was 61.05 ampere. We'll discuss it at the end of this lecture, why the short circuit current is decreasing at bus number 34. Let us observe first how the short circuit current is occurring. So this is for maximum, that is for half cycle. Let us see for 1.5 to 4 cycle. Now here if we see, there is not much variation because no component is connected between the grid and the bus. So the short circuit current, you will not observe much variation in the short circuit current, and minimum also it is going to be. So the operating range for short circuit current near to the grid side is very narrow. So let us now observe the duty cycle. Now the same 13.48 kilo ampere current which was contributing for the fault which was at bus number 2, now if we have created, that means the distance has increased from the wind turbine generator. Now as the distance is increasing, the fault current is going to get decreased. So here if we see, the short circuit current is 4.5 kilo ampere, and towards which is contributing 0.479 kilo ampere from the wind turbine generator, and from the grid side it is 39.19 kiloampere, which is contributing overall is 39.4 kiloampere. That is, it is the sum of the short circuit current which is coming from the grid side and from the wind turbine generators. So let us now see, observe if we have created a short circuit fault on both the buses. Now I'm creating a fault, simultaneous fault, on bus number 2 as well as bus number 34. When I have created a fault, let us observe what is the maximum current. Now if we see, the maximum current at bus number 2 is 61.05 and bus number 34 is 39.3 kiloampere. Now when a fault is created, as you go away from the generator, the short circuit current is going to get decreased. So if we see at bus number 2, which is close to the generator, it is having more short circuit current, and bus number 34, which is far from the generators, its short circuit current has decreased. So the value has already been indicated. Let us see for 1.5 to 4 cycle, again if we see, then there is not much difference at bus number 34. And if we see for 30 cycle, this is the lower range, you can call the lower limit of that short circuit current at both the buses. If we perform the duty cycle, it will show you the maximum current, 13.48 kilo ampere, which is contributing to both buses at bus number 2 as well as bus number 34. Along with this, now what is the purpose of doing this short circuit analysis? Now we have studied how the short circuit fault is occurring and what are the values and how to run it in ETAP software. So basically this is used to select the protective devices, ratings of the protective devices, so that the power system is operating in a very good condition. Now along with this, we can generate a report. If we have to display a report, like whatever the analysis we have carried out, what is the input we have given at that particular wind turbine generator, so it is going to generate a report. So I'll have to create a click on report manager. So this is a report manager. I'll click on report manager, select complete option, and whichever format you want, you can select that. So for example, if I select PDF and click OK, it is showing you the name and title part, that is the file name which is going to be saved, and it is going to show you the path where the file is going to be saved. I'll click on OK. So the report is getting generated. So it is displaying the entire output which we have studied. So the study case is the short circuit along with the file name. So this is showing you the number of buses which we have considered, one swing bus, one branch that is of transformer, one machine that is we have considered for power grid. Along with this, we have considered whatever we have considered, the bus input, that is one load bus operating at 690 volt and swing bus which is operating at 33 kilowatt. It is going to display the entire result along with the short circuit current. So in each and every branch, this result is available for further analysis. Okay, so that's it for this session. In the next module, we will cover about the harmonic analysis and the transient analysis. Thank you.